हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल सी द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ मॉडल ऑर्गेनिजम्स। मॉडल ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर यूज्ड टू स्टडी अ पर्टिकुलर बायोलॉजिकल फेनोमेनन एट अ सेल, टिश्यू, ऑर्गन और ऑर्गन सिस्टम लेवल ऑफ एन ऑर्गेनिज्म। वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ मॉडल ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर यूज्ड इन द बायोलॉजी। A model organism is chosen according to which research is to be performed. For example, most of genetics research or for mutation studies, Drosophila melanogaster, that is fruit fly, which has 60-70% genome homologous to humans, is used. Other organisms are also used, but Drosophila usage is more common in studying genetics. For developmental studies, frogs and chickens are used. So, these are, that is, model organisms are powerful tools to study biology or various biological principles. These organisms are used to study genes, gene mutations, anatomy, physiology, various kinds of diseases, etc. Now, why model organisms are required? As we all know that human beings or human embryos cannot be used for the scientific studies. So this is the main reason why model organisms are required. Also, morally and ethically, we would not want to perform experiments on humans and human embryos. Observation is also difficult inside the human uterus. Also, we cannot breed human beings to see the effects of genes or effects of gene mutation on the embryos. Therefore, researchers study development in model organisms to identify general principles of biology. Now, which are the different kinds of model organisms that are used in the biology? These are either invertebrates or vertebrate animals, as well as plant model organisms are also used for some of the studies. Now, the model organism is mainly dependent upon the type of study that we want to perform. Invertebrate animals that are used are the fruit fly, Drosophila melanogaster, then the nematode worm, C. elegans. For vertebrate study, the organisms, most common organisms used, the frog, Xenopus laevis, chicken, Gallus gallus, mouse, Mus musculus, then zebrafish, Danio rerio, and the plant model organism, which is a member of a mustard family, Arabidopsis thalina, is most commonly used. So these are the invertebrate animals. Drosophila melanogaster is most of the time studied for, or is used as a model organism for study of genetics or to study gene mutations. Then for developmental studies or apoptosis studies, C. elegans is used, which is a nematode worm. Then for developmental biology studies, Xenopus laevis, frog, and chickens, that is Gallus gallus, are used. For most of the mammalian studies, the mouse, Mus musculus, white mouse or black mouse, are used. And for some of the scientific studies, zebrafish, Danio rerio is also used. So these are the most common invertebrate and vertebrate animals model organisms that are used in the scientific studies. Then if prokaryote is to be studied, or if for a particular experiment simple model organism is required, then E. coli can be used. Then if simple eukaryotic model organism is to be used, then yeast, that is Saccharomyces cerevisiae, is used. And again, a plant model organism, Arabidopsis thalina, is also used. Now, what is the exact definition of a model organism? A model organism is a non-human species that is extensively studied to understand particular biological phenomena with the expectation that discoveries made in The organism model will provide insight into the workings of other organisms. That is, studies done in one organism should be reciprocative in other animals, especially in the human beings. So, in the next lecture, we will see which criteria are used for choosing or for selecting model organism. Thank you for watching. If you like the contents, then please like, share and subscribe my channel. If you have any suggestions, then provide them in the comment box. Thank you again.